Ouch, that looks painful. Can it be removed? What happens next? Keep watching to find out. This is a Be Kind to Pets veterinary educational video sponsored by Payoh Vets. This video is about surgical treatment of an ear abscess in a terrapin. Let's listen to today's case history.
December 23, 2005, this terrapin around 2 years old has a very big ear abscess. I think it's the biggest one I've seen. And the two daughters were told by the mother to look for a terrapin vet. But they were too busy. And finally the mother said maybe to throw away this terrapin. So they Google the internet and found Payoh Vets. So this is how I got to see this terrapin today. This terrapin is still eating, it's for several months. And what happened is, according to the mother, the terrapin will eat towards the right side because the left side is painful.
So what is an abscess? An abscess is a swollen area filled with bacteria and pus. In this case, it was located in the ear. Abscesses do not happen overnight and take some time to develop. In this case, it had been several months before the owner decided to seek treatment. Let's listen to why this terrapin developed an abscess.
How come it caused this one? Infection.
Because
is it of the water, the deep one?
You change water every day?
My mother, this one, my house have two. My one is okay, very healthy. My mother, I think the water sometimes very dirty. I tell her you must 3 days change already, water, because of the water.
Yeah, this is a tank without filter, right?
Without filter?
Without sunlight.
If without water, without sunlight, then must need to change the water?
Better change every day or so, because it's very dirty, right?
No. Oh yeah, this one water cannot be dirty.
This one it seems to be a hardened lump. So the recommendation is to lance in the incise the big abscess, let all the hardened parts come out.
Let's look at the surgery.
The terrapin with ear abscess is anesthetized, isoflurane, okay, take out. Then we will take out and then cut along the lower part, the ventral, scalpel blade, the lower part, lower one, so that the red one, the reddish part, long one, about 1 centimeter, not small, long one, yeah. So it's not so painful for him. Then the curette is here, the curette, to cure out the pus. So, put on the, you can see the pus, it's a thick pus. A lot of things to come up, yeah. More and more, yeah. Okay, Strange press up, see whether I can express up. ...1:51 PM, the abscess had been lanced and removed from this terrapin. Terrapin was under isoflurane anesthesia and still hasn't woken up yet. Terrapins can be anesthetized using isoflurane gas, although they are said they will withhold their breath to stop breathing in the gas, but actually they don't do it. The ear is still swollen, but the thick pus and exudate has been taken out. So this swelling is due to the blood hematoma. We will check again tomorrow. But terminally he has recovered from anesthesia and it looks very active.
Here are some tips and advice.
See the vet early so that the abscess can be drained much earlier, and also is less painful to the terrapin now with this big infection. It's about 1 centimeter at least across. Yeah. Then the other thing is change water every day. If you have a small tank, If you have a small tank, then you cannot afford to let it be dirty. There should be an area for the terrapin to dry up, yeah. And some sunlight if possible.
So, what happened to our terrapin?
This terrapin has been here for 8 days and was treated for the ear abscess. Now, the ear abscess was the largest I've seen, but they have been taken out, as you can see earlier on in the video. And now, the swelling is actually due to inflammation and clotted blood. It has already reduced about 50%. It's on the 8th day. And appetite is excellent. It's eating and active, and so you can go home. And it will take another 1 month for the swelling to go down.
If you think your terrapin has an ear abscess, feel free to contact our Payoh vets. For more information, please visit the following link.